हेलो, टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस अबाउट एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग इन पीएचपी। एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग इन पीएचपी, यू नो एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग फ्रॉम जावा, एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग फ्रॉम सी प्लस प्लस। एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग मीन्स इफ एरर ऑकर्स इन योर प्रोग्राम देन इट कैन बी हैंडल्ड विथ एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग। इट कैन बी हैंडल्ड एंड प्रोग्राम कंटिन्यूली एग्जीक्यूटेड। इफ ओनली एरर, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन एरर एंड एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग? इफ एरर ऑकर्स इन योर प्रोग्राम then it will give the error and program will stop there. In exception handling, if error occurred, then it can handled by try and catch block. Here it is a powerful mechanism which is used to handle runtime errors. Here, an exception is an unexpected outcome of a program which can be handled by the program itself. Then, what is the try, catch and throw, and finally, four keywords are there in exception handling. Exception handling allows you to handle runtime errors such as IO exception, SQL exception, class not found exception and more. Various system defined exceptions are there. A most popular example of exception handling is divide by zero, you know that, which is an arithmetic exception. Various categories are there for exception. One of the categories arithmetic exception and example is divide by zero exception. Exception handling is almost similar in all programming languages, in C++, Java or PHP. When an exception occurs inside the try block during runtime of code, it is caught and resolved in catch block. Exception occurs in try and exception resolves in catch block. The try block must be followed by catch or finally block. A try block can be followed by minimum one and maximum any number of catch blocks. One try and multiple catch blocks also allowed. And whenever there is a try, then at least one catch block is required to handle the exception. The catch block contains the code that executes when a specified exception is thrown. It is thrown in try block. If exception is thrown in try block, then it is caught by catch block. It is always used with a try block, not alone. Try and catch. Catch is followed by try. When an exception occurs, PHP finds the matching catch block. Throw, it is a keyword used to throw an exception. It is also helped to list all the exceptions that a function throws but doesn't handle itself. Each throw must have at least one catch. The finally block contains a code which is used for cleanup activity in PHP. It executes the essential code of the program. The finally block, it is a cleanup activity, means if you open the file, if you open the database, then closing operations are required. It is a default code which is executed at the end of program. What happens when an exception is triggered? The current state of code is saved. The execution of the code is switched to a predefined exception handler function. and then depending on the situation, the handler can halt the execution of a program, resume the execution from the saved code state, or continue the execution of the code from another location in the code. As per the logic of the code, if exception triggered, then it will caught by the catch block. After that, it handles the exception and continue the program execution, means resume the execution of the saved code state. Advantages of exception handling over error handling. In traditional error handling, if else block is used to handle errors, it makes the code unreadable because the code for handling errors and conditions got mixed. Within the try catch block, exception keeps separate from the code and code become readable. Using try and catch block, we can easily identify where the error occurs and how to handle that. Let us see the example of exception handling. Here we have to define one function which name is check number, and one number is passed to there. If dollar number is greater than equal to 1, if number greater than equal to 1, then exception occurs. If less than 1, then exception not occur. Then number greater than equal to 1, throw new exception, value must be less than 1, return to end of the function. If this function, we have to, after in try block, we have to call this function and pass the parameter 5, number 5, then it will call that function and check if number is greater than equal to 1, then it throws the exception and it caught by catch block. Then it will display the message exception. This is the predefined functions, exception handling functions, which take the message from exception and display it. Exception message, value must be less than 1. Whenever the exception occurs, it will switch to catch block and then execute the program and then return it will display the message here, value must be less than 1. When you enter value less than 1, it will executes other remaining lines of the program. Another example, that is a custom exception or user defined exception. How to define our own exception? Here class divide by zero exception extends exception. You know the inheritance, we have to extend the divide by zero exception, extends exception. Divide by negative no exception, extends exception. Two classes are there, divide by zero exception and divide by negative no exception. One function is there, check divisor. Here two parameters are there, divisor and dividend. If divisor is equal to 0, then which exception is required? Divide by zero exception. Else if divide by negative no exception. And else if values are correct, not less than 0, equal to 0, if these conditions are false, then dividend divided by divisor and the result of division and displays. Whenever this exception occurs, it will caught by this divide by 0 exception and it will display divide by 0 exception message. If this exception occurs, then it will caught by divide by negative no exception, and otherwise default it will take unknown exception. Here, first 18 by 3 is equal to 6. It will calculate the result and display the result. Divide by 0 exception, check divisor, it will give divide by 0 exception, and divide by negative number, then it will give this message, multiple catch blocks. And we have to define our own definition for every exception, that is a user defined exception. Next, one more important keyword here, throw. Throw is a keyword that is used to throw an exception. One try and multiple catch blocks also are there. Here, syntax of try, try block, and then catch block, exception, dollar E, where to pass the object, and then finally, it is always executed if exception occurs or not occurs, then it will in both cases final block is executed. Here the try block must be followed by a catch or finally block. A try block must have at least one catch block, and there can be multiple catch blocks with one try block. Catch block, there can be more than one block with a try. The thrown exception is caught and resolved by one or more catch. The catch block is always used with a try block. It cannot be used alone. It comes just after the try block. It is throw, it is a keyword which is used to throw an exception. One throw at least has one catch block. It leaves the exception thrown by function which cannot be handled by the function itself. And finally, block is also used for cleanup activity in PHP. Here, user defined function with an exception. Here, check number, same example, greater than equal to 1. Then value must be less than 1. If greater than equal to 1, then it will execute. Otherwise, greater than equal to 1, then throw an exception. Value must be less than 1. Here we have to pass the number, check 5. It will caught the exception because value is greater than equal to 1. Then exception message, it will take value must be less than 1. It will display value must be less than 1. And finally, it will execute it finally block. It is final block which always executes. User defined function with an exception. Here, test even dollar number. If number modulus 2 is equal to 1, then throw an exception. Pass number is an odd number. After throw, this statement will not execute. Okay. Here, it will caught by this catch block, and it will display pass number is an odd number. Test even 19. It will check is equal to 1. Therefore, it will caught by exception and it will give the message. First, odd number is passed there, an exception message is displayed. output for odd number. Exception में से pass number is an odd number. Okay, then and finally block. Even number, if you pass even number here, then it will display output for even number, and then it will display this else part here. The pass value is an even number, and finally block. Here, custom exception and multiple catch statement. In the below example, we'll create a custom exception class that extends the exception class. Multiple catch blocks with a single try block. Here, class odd number exception extends exception. Then we have to define user defined exception. If number percent to modulus 2 is equal to 1, then throws an exception, odd number exception, even number exception. Multiple catch blocks are there. Without multiple catch blocks, above example is there, and here as per the exception type, it will give multiple catch blocks. It executes multiple catches. Whenever the exception occurs, it will find the matching catch block for that exception and then execute the code. Here, output for even number 28, then it will check which is equal to 1, then it will odd number exception. Here, exception message, it will catch by this exception because it is even. If you see this text, the pass value is even number. Else part it will execute. Otherwise, odd, as if it is odd, then it will display exception message that is odd number. These are the basic concepts of PHP exception handling: try, catch, throw, and finally. These are the main basic keywords which are used in exception handling: multiple catch block, try, catch followed by multiple catch statements are there. At least one try and one catch block is required to handle the exception. Multiple catch blocks are also allowed for the try. According to category, according to exception, it will check the, it will select the catch statement as per the type of exception. It will search matching catch. And finally, it is the cleanup activity which is always executed at the end of program. Here, predefined exceptions are there. Get message returns the message to be displayed when exception occurs. Get previous exceptions are returned. Get code, the code for exception generated. Get file, the file in which exception occurs is returned. Get line, the number of line in which exception occurs return. Get trace, the stack trace is returned. So many functions are there which is defined by the system for the exception handling. Line, file, code, and message. These are the function name. Important: get message, get previous, get code, get file, get line. Important messages are there. I hope you understood the concept of exception handling in PHP. exception handling in PHP. Here, nested try catch in PHP. Nested try catch here. Here in this example, first you have to define one try block which upload file testfile.php, then catch exception $e. Here echo $e get message while $e is equal to get previous, echo previous error and get message function upload file. Here upload file is another function which is called in try block. We have to define that function upload file. Here we have to pass the parameter $filename and again inside the function we have to define try block. If file exists $filename, suppose any code, and else throw new exception file not found. Catch exception $e. It is a part of function, that is try and catch block is the part of function, and in try we have to define call that function and it also handles by catch, caught by the catch function. It is called nested try catch block in one try. We have to call that function and in that function we have to define another try. By passing exception classes previous error instance, we can capture nested exception, and this program will return the following output. Here it will give error unable to upload file and previous error file not found. See, the first we have to define our try upload file. Whenever it caught the function, whenever it calls, it will execute that function upload file, and in if file exists it will display code, otherwise throw a new exception file not found. Then it will check caught by the exception unable to upload file. First we have to display unable to upload file because it is inner part of the function. Then after that it will unable to upload file, it will goes to this it will give error, therefore it will not upload. Then if this exception caught by this catch, and then it will display first it displays unable to upload file because this is the message for unable to upload file, and then get previous. Previous means this, it is give file not found error. First it will take the existing message and then it will display previous error. get previous and display while $e is equal to $e get previous. Then previous error is equal to get message. It will rewrite the message that is file not found. By passing exception classes previous error instance, we can capture nested exception, and this program will return the following output. Try to execute this program. When you execute this program, then you will understood the meaning of this program. I hope you will understood the custom exceptions, user defined exceptions, try, catch, finally, throw, predefined exception functions, predefined functions for exceptions, and nested try catch. Thank you.